ओके,
हाउ आर यू डूइंग?
आई एम डूइंग ग्रेट. व्हाट अबाउट यू?
आई एम गुड. वेल एक्चुअली आई वांटेड टू ask your full name because you know I see your email as MS Nagda, but I don't know the full form of MS.
My name is Mahesh Nagda.
Mahesh, okay. Nagda, okay.
Nagda, yeah.
Okay, so Mahesh, do you want to go with the topic of the day or some general topic?
Today's topic is interesting, so we can go with the topic.
Okay, the topic is interesting. Age, okay. So, let's just talk about the age first. Like, you know, what is the importance of age in our life? So, what do you think? Like, first of all, I'd like to know, you are 23 years old, right?
Yeah, 22 or 3 something. Yeah.
20. Okay. So, are you fine with what age you are at now? Are you okay with that? Or do you like, you know, do you don't like anything about your age?
No, I'm happy with my age, whatever stage that I am. Nothing wrong with that, because every stage of life has its own importance and own responsibility and role. Different role we play at the different stage of life. So
Exactly.
there is nothing wrong with this age of my life.
Exactly. Okay. So is there any age group which you don't like?
I would say there is nothing. Or there is no age group which I don't like, unless just imagine if someone is very old and he is bedridden, then that can be a little bit problematic. But apart from that, I don't find any age stage that I don't like. Every
Yeah,
age is own
every
importance.
age has its own importance. Exactly. There has not been any age which we don't like. Because we have to go through age also. Like, we also have to go through that period of our life. So
Whether
we are
we
not
want
supposed
or
to
not.
dislike. Yeah, exactly. If you know, yeah, if someone is saying that, oh, I don't like old people, you do have to go through that age also. Yeah,
yeah.
You do have to go through that. So you are not supposed to unlike, you know, any age group. Okay. So,
I believe that when we used to be kids, so what we used to think that that we when we will be young and we will enjoy much
Yeah,
more
exactly.
that now. But now what we think that that we wish that we can go back in those our childhood days.
Yeah.
What
The
that we were,
opposite things happen. Yeah.
yeah, so that's what we were discussing in the last session, that we should live in the present and enjoy the present. The present is also very good, and the when that this time will left, you will remember this time and feel this, oh, this time was also good, but I couldn't enjoy that because I was regretting for the past and planning for the future, but not enjoying the present.
Yes, I guess we should never regret about our past, and also at the same time we should not, you know, think too much about our future. All we have right now is present, so that's
Okay.
what we should think about, that's what we should enjoy, right? Okay. So I'd like to know if you have any sibling.
Yes, I have a younger brother.
Okay, so he is younger than you. Okay, what age group he is in right now?
Probably 16 or 15.
16 or
Teenager.
15. Okay, he is a teenager. Okay, so I'd like you to mention me some, you know, few factors that you like about teenage group and not about your age group.
Okay, so in teenage that we don't much concern about the future and the responsibilities. In we have
Yeah,
all like
we are reckless. We are careless.
We don't need for the future. We don't need to take big decision of our life. But as we enter the adulthood, then we have lots of responsibility. Like we have to choose a career, we have to plan for the future, we have to find a good girl for our life. So, or maybe girl, then it's boy for them. So then we have to take a big decision for our life that is going to decide our life direction. That how we are going to be after 5 or 10 years, or maybe throughout our life. That decision going to impact our life till the last.
Yes, exactly. And also I think sometimes Mahesh, age doesn't matter, I guess. You know,
Yeah.
sometimes we are in such circumstances that we have to become responsible even in the teenage group, right?
Yeah.
When, you know, for suppose that we don't have our father or we don't have mother, so we have to become responsible for our siblings and, you know, take responsibility of home, household things. So we are the, you know, elder one of our home. So sometimes, you know, circumstances occur that we have to take responsibility. And
So
also, one more thing I'd like to ask you. I have heard people saying that, you know, he's underage, then he's not matured enough. And he is 20 or 21, then he should be matured enough. Then tell me one thing. Do you also think that, you know, maturity has a link with age?
no, I don't think this at all, because maturity has nothing to do with the age. I've seen many
Exactly.
people, those are younger than me but more mature than me, and I've seen many people, those are elder than me but still not that much mature. So I think it depends on the responsibility and the circumstances of their life they have gone through that make them more mature or less mature. So I don't think that age group has something to do with the maturity.
Okay. Acha, what do you think are the factors that influences our maturity? What factors do we need to, you know, experience in order to get matured?
Outside, it's all about responsibility.
Responsibility.
The more responsible you will be, the more mature you will start being. Because
Okay.
yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. No, okay, you continue.
Yeah, so in our teenage, that we didn't have much responsibility. If you talk about, there is a guy who is just for 15 years old, but taking care of his family, earning some money, whether doing job anywhere, then definitely he's going to be more matured than those who have privilege that don't need to work that much. Definitely, this will be the case.
Yes, exactly. And also, I'd like to ask you, do our parents play any role, you know, in our maturity?
Yeah, to a certain extent, I would say.
Certain.
So, the reason is that if parents is like taking care of a guy even after 20s, or then treating him like a kid and giving them all the facilities and
Then
all
he's
the things,
not going to be
then
responsible.
yeah, responsible.
Yeah.
On the other hand, if someone who is not that much privileged and her parents is not like making him dependent on them, then he's going to be mature.
Yes, okay. Okay, so my last question would be, I have seen, you know, I'd like to tell you one thing. You know, there is a whole lifespan of girls when they are, you know, kids, they are the responsibility of their parents. And when they are in a teenage group, you know, they are supposed to, you know, keep hidden so that, you know, they don't get any incident in their life. And when they are married, they are the responsibility of their husbands or in-laws. So do you think that age is a factor which keeps girls backward in the society?
For age, I don't think there is nothing to do with the age. But in this today's scenario, in this day scenario, seen that there is nothing like that. Girls is also being independent. They are not being dependent on the parents and the in-laws' parents or maybe husband. They are now, as we are working toward the gender equality, so this will be one day over. So both male
Okay,
and will
so
be
you think that government is working on gender equality? Do you really think
yes
that? Okay, in
yes
what
but
way?
many ways they are doing, though they are giving reservation to the girls so that they can come forward in as compared to men, and changing the name, just like earlier in if I talk about cricket, they would used to be batsman but now it's better, so it can be a girl or it can be a boy. Businessman, now we are talking about the business man or woman, so now we are talking about business person, chairperson. So these are the things are getting changed.
Yes, exactly. Okay. I appreciate with your thoughts. Like, I also do think the same thing. Okay. I'd like to ask you that, you know, You must also have heard that, you know, when our parents are old, it's our responsibility, you know, to take care of themselves and to look after them. So, are you satisfied with that thought that, you know, children also take care of their parents as much as their parents do of their children? Is this justifiable?
No, I don't think that we can care our parents as much as they did.
Yes,
Yeah,
exactly.
try to make them happy, to be hell outside, to be the in the old age. We can be the support of them. But if we are comparing both of them and saying them the both are equal, I don't think they are not equal at all. We can't do sacrifice that much they have done for us.
Yes, exactly. And I'd like to know the reason why children cannot sacrifice their everything for their parents, but parents can sacrifice everything for their children. You know, what is the difference between both of the scenes?
It's a very typical question for me, but I still would say that because we have grown up in the arms of our parents, when we were kids, our parents give us everything that we wanted. But what happened that now in today's generation, like we people in our generation, kids don't that much care about parents. They think like it's okay, and they don't much serious about those parents. But parents used to be serious, and they wanted us to give everything that we wanted. They want to give us happy life, good life. That every time when we ask our parents for money, even they would give us even little bit more than we have asked for. So there are many things that children and parents. So I would say that parents love is. Also, every time I would say far more than ours.
Yes, exactly. We can never, you know, match to that point.
There
Yes,
is
we
no
can never
comparison.
match. Yeah, there is no comparison actually. Okay, so let's talk about the feedback. First of all,
Okay.
the thing I'd like to tell you is, you know, the way you speak by going inside the topic, that is brilliant. Like, you know, you just get into the character. If I'm talking about age, then, you know, you are just thinking about the age and just age, not anything else. So that is very, you know, appreciable. And yeah, one last thing I, you know, mentioned last time is that eye contact. You need to work little bit on that. Well, everything was very good. And also, you know, your topics are interconnected. I don't find it difficult to, you know, link your sentences. It's, you know, overall it was very good. And the only thing you need to work on is your eye contact. And also, the last question I asked you about, you know, the comparison between parents' love and children love, you know, you got a bit of nervous, right? So you don't have to get nervous. Just, you know, go with the flow, talk whatever you have in your mind, right? It doesn't matter whether you are saying it wrong or right. What matters is that you are talking. That's all we want, right?
Okay.
So overall, it was very good. And according to you, how was the conversation?
Yeah, according to me, it was good, and it can be better.
It can be better. And also, it is better than before.
Okay, comparatively
Yeah,
better.
you are doing better, and that's a very good thing about you. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.